I was trying to be nice.
All right, so one person is attacking you.
Okay.
That is a 7D, right? Or wait, no.
Yes.
Yes, here.
7D.
There, all right, so 7D, cool. Misses you.
Okay.
All right, so you're up on the top of this thing.
Yes.
You know, you can see what's going on at the wall. There's a lot of people getting, you know, hit. A few are starting to get through the wall. But you're trapped up here because this fucking guy keeps going around and looking for you. It's as if he's got your scent, but he's not sure which way you went. He keeps going around the same building.
Is there, do we have like a pit or something? Like a town
an
pit?
Like a hole or?
Bear pit?
Yeah, like the sacred hole.
Like yeah. Roll luck.
there would be pits and things, yeah.
Like a dangerous pit?
Well, there's Dead probably hole. A latrine or something.
I want to try.
Oh, roll around in the latrine.
No, I'm sorry.
If you roll around,
no.
If you roll
no,
around
no,
the latrine.
No,
I'm sorry I said it.
No,
I'm sorry I said it.
No,
I'm really sorry.
Sifatrex, do not submit any donations. We will not accept them.
No, I'm sorry I even said it. I apologize.
I'll accept them. I'm not going to tell you guys.
Oh, okay, that's true. Go ahead and donate. We're not gonna do it.
We're talking about the latrine family. Wes was saying there's probably
they
one
started
latrine
the,
wandering by.
Yes.
What? Yes. I learned from the latrine.
It's historically accurate. The latrines did start the whole digging for going to the bathroom.
They made that up.
They made
and
that
we
up.
Know that. It started here in Stavanger. Look
another...
it up on Wikipedia in about 12 hours.
Look at all these facts.
There will be a Reddit link.
No. It won't be red. It'll be blue because they'll reference this video.
Citation.
Citation.
I got to get rid of this guy.
Do you have stealth?
It is on my sheet.
So you have 25.
I have 20. I can't.
What?
Oh yeah, 20.
Mine's 25.
Well, mine's 20.
My sheet said 20.
Oh no, mine says 20.
Mine says 20 too.
Well, I would like to. So he's circling the building that I am on,
mm-hmm.
like in this general area.
Yeah, he's followed your.
Can I
footsteps.
Like throw something off of the roof, like somewhere else, to like try and make noise?
Give me a throw roll.
This has worked so well in the past.
What? It works for Batman like every time.
This is like a Jedi mind trick thing. You're gonna make him think he hears a pebble over.
No, he will hear a pebble over there.
Yep.
Or will he? No, he will not.
What'd you roll?
45.
What's your throw?
What's your throw?
It's on my sheet, so it's a 25.
Gotcha.
So do you want to push it?
I do not.
You just hit him in the head.
you throw this rock.
You don't say distraction when you throw the rock.
I'm over here. Over here.
But where the rock is.
I'm that way.
I'm a rock now.
Damn it. Will you go away? I got away from you. So you throw a rock and it was like
right in front of the building.
Well, it's like me throwing dice at this cup. It just doesn't work.
So it goes way too far.
It overshoots, hits the wall, hits back, and he goes and looks right up at you.
Okay, I freeze.
I can see you. And he starts climbing the wall.
His vision was based on movement. We already established.
It's canon.
Canon. So he starts climbing the wall.
Oh my gosh, he's been blessed by a Gandalf.
He speaks really well, too.
I see you, I'm coming at the wall.
Yeah, that sounds more like Sifatrex.
There you go.
Like he's got 10 marshmallows in his mouth.
All the time.
Because he's always eating marshmallows for some reason.
Too many marshmallows.
It's a weird troll.
Anyway, he's up to you.
Okay, so I'm going to try. He's climbing.
See what you gotta do.
He's climbing up. The side of the building, and I'm.
Ooh!
Oh, Ponin noobs!
Woo!
Punin noobs! Thanks for calling us.
Thanks, Ponin.
Correct us if we said that wrong, but I'm pretty sure that's how you would say it.
Punin noobs!
I want to try and climb down the back of the building, away from
him. Okay, so he's climbing up.
Yeah.
Make a climb roll.
Oh, can't we just skip that?
Climb.
Yeah, I climbed!
Yes.
Woohoo!
I did some clim.
You're supposed to be the smart one. Come on.
My character is smart.
I did some
I'm the one saying that.
So, you're running, you're doing your thing. This creature has passed by you. Yeah. It's probably about 9 feet tall with these huge horned teeth off its back, all the way down, spiny back teeth, okay. Back teeth.
But like, I'm scared of teeth.
I know, I'm
okay,
I'm just
I'm trying to clarify.
Yeah, no,
okay,
no,
so,
you're
okay.
Fine, I'm just joking.
Rear ears.
So, rear ears. And it's got this like, it looks like really thick green skin. And it doesn't walk, it doesn't look like it's walking very well on land. I do need you to make a sand check now that you're up close to this thing.
Okay.
Is it walking like it's wearing swim flippers?
Kinda.
Yeah, I made that. 46.
Okay, cool. So you still take a point of sand. She
now
takes
I
a point of sand on.
78.
Do we have a napkin at all anywhere?
Dom has some.
I just need one because the condensation from the...
I have a pug.
No.
We
can't use a pug as a napkin. That's cruel.
Especially after all the
That's
ones you killed.
Whatever.
Killer. Pug killer.
Those pugs were
good. Good job.
They
kill
were robot
pugs.
Exploding. They weren't
well, they
real.
Weren't
what?
What?
They were robot pugs.
They
were.
No, they weren't robot pugs, were they?
They were robot
they were.
Pugs.
They weren't real.
I thought they were
created.
No, I mean, I wanted them to be real, but...
And I said robot. They were,
yeah, they were robot pugs.
They were robots.
They were robot,
for
Jordan.
For the SPCA.
Yeah.
Ah,
12.
Yes, yes.
We're not the dog's life here.
Okay.
All right.
A dog's porpoise.
A dog's life.
We don't believe in animal cruelty. We're not a dog's
we're
life.
We're not a dog's life.
So okay. I want to, what I want to try to do is essentially, you said it doesn't look like it is dealing with land well.
No, and you guys are on a steep incline because you're on the side of a mountain.
Where are the other ones from where
the other ones are a little bit farther down. They're about 15 to 20 feet apart.
Are these on all fours or on two legs?
They're on two legs, but they're kind of like, you know, weird looking.
What's above me? How rocky is it? How tough is the terrain?
It gets tougher as you go up. But like I said, there's like bushes and ice and snow and trees it looks like this was the land. Somehow the Vikings started here sliding down. So okay. Any higher, it gets a little rocky.
Well, first thing I want to try to do is stab it. But I want to go for like I would either go through the throat or, but it doesn't sound like
it doesn't
I can
really
reach
have
that.
A throat. It has more of a mound kind
okay.
of situation.
Back of the knee.
Then yeah, I'd probably try to go for its legs since it already seems to be struggling.
Then that way it could say I took a sword in the knee and I can't be an adventurer.
Yeah. Was it you that was telling me that's that is actually a reference to a marriage proposal.
Oh really?
Taking
yeah.
an arrow to the knee was a phrase when you went down on one knee to propose to someone. So what that guy in Skyrim is actually saying is I used to be an adventurer like you, but then I got married.
Yeah, what was the reason? Like, took an arrow is supposed to be like, you know, like Cupid.
Well, that makes it
and
really
the knee
cool.
is dropping to a knee to propose.
That's really cool. Yeah.
So is this on Wikipedia?
I don't know where this was.
Is it,
you
this
saw it somewhere.
No, you saw it.
It's on Wikipedia.
You told me.
No, you told me about it. One of us told the other one about it, and we're not entirely sure who did it. But apparently it is semi-historically accurate.
Hey, can Elder Gods, look it up.
Please.
Tell us if they're right.
Fakwad, yes, if you're yes. there, you're the internet. Can you let us know if
you're
it's right?
The internet.
But specifically,
Fakwad,
don't look
the
at
Matrix.
The Wikia for Skyrim.
Thank you.
Or Bethesda.
But
stay away from those two. But like,
all right.
That's Ben's turf.
That's my turf.
That's my turf. Okay, so give me a roll. I'm going to give you advantage because you are sneaking up behind him.
Okay, so let me find my other deck. All right, so this is sword, right? I mean. That I'm rolling here?
Right.
Sword.
Don't mind
sword,
me.
Sword.
Drink.
Yes, I made it with my 41, not that crazy 91 over there.
All right, yes. So do damage.
Okay.
How well of a roll did you do? Like, what's your
I got
sword?
A 41. My sword is 75, so it's not... I
mean, so is that that's not half, is no. it? Mm-hmm. So you didn't make a hard success, you made a standard success. Okay,
yes.
Cool.
And then, let's see. 2d6. Oh, that's sad. Four.
Almost
four points. Okay.
Almost the minimum amount of damage.
So
really?
You go,
I thought I had more die than that. Okay.
Four.
When you stab this creature, Oh, Forsaken.
Woohoo! Thank you.
Oh, thanks, Forsaken.
I guess I should turn on my monitor and see what that $25 is for.
It's for
being cool guys?
Yeah, giving us cupcakes.
Cupcakes?
Give the players cupcakes. Hey.
Pizza party.
Whee!
We all read our reading for the summer.
I never knew that.
I was wondering what that tray of cupcakes that Dom had over there. Now he can give them to us.
Give us the cupcakes, Dom.
Dom.
Yeah, come on.
Dom's being a dick.
For those of you at home, Dom mimed that he was throwing cupcakes at us and we all reacted. It was very funny.
We really need to have a producer cam.
We do. You're right, we do.
But then he'd have to wear a shirt.
Yeah. It's true.
And pants.
He only puts them on when he goes in front of the camera. Yeah. And then he gets back over there and takes it all
instantly
off.
Instantly strips. We try not to look over there.
We try not to look that way, but every once in a while.
You can't help but look.
You just get a full...
Full eye load of Dom.
Full eye load of Dom.
Dom?
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, the full Dom. Hold on.
Okay.
Forsaken.
What did you do?
Forsaken, what did you do?
We cool? We cool?
I don't know. I mean, his name is Forsaken.
Mine!
No!
I have four rerolls!
You see what
I have three rerolls!
Quick, guys, remember, he can't see where the rerolls went.
I get another one! I'm not Mr. fucking Magoo. Where's he at? All right, so.
Are those rerolls or push-its?
They're rerolls for him. He gets rerolls.
So, this you stabbed in this creature and it's not, it's
working?
Like, it's the skin is really tough.
Okay.
And it turns around.
What I want to do is take off running up the mountain and see if I can get it to follow me.
Okay, just so you know, these creatures are not like the basic ones that are down there.
Okay.
So they will get to defend and attack back and all that.
Okay.
All right. So we go to you. Now, am I correct in reading that the thing that you read, the thing that you put is for this fight I'm about to do?
What?
Sure.
I just, you put a word in there and I want to know which bear you're talking about. This one?
The only bear.
I think this one. Okay. So.
Uh-huh.
All of these creatures are attacking you.
Uh-huh.
And suddenly they just scatter. And this one creature comes out of the water.
Is it the Ivan Drago of these creatures?
Yes. It's this really, it's this huge creature.
It says, which translates to, I must break you.
It's got like tentacles coming out of its side, and arms. And it's about a foot taller than you. And all of them scatter around and start to go towards you guys, right?
Okay.
They're just avoiding you because you keep killing them all.
Uh-huh.
And this big one, and it's coming right for you. It starts to run towards you. Thank you, Forsaken. So
it's terrifying.
Running
Forsaken.
Straight for you. Mm-hmm. I need you to make a sand check because this is
cool cat.
A lot.
212. Thanks for
cool
the follow.
Cat.
Hey, thanks, cool cat. Thanks cool
for tuning in to Cool Cat 212. Every night.
61 over my 50.
Okay, roll against your intelligence to see if you understand the full depth of holy shit.
Do you?
I absolutely get it.
Yay.
I absolutely understand tentacle monster.
Tentacle monster.
Oh no.
Tentacle monster. 10 points of sand.
Oh, man.
I instantly latrine myself.
That was horrible. Your bear brain cannot take whatever the fuck this is.
I don't know about the woods, but the bear at the docks, that's what I'm saying.
Hey, now you.
Wait, he does what? Wait, what does he do?
No,
at the docks?
No, stop. Stop.
Hey, keep keeping it clean.
Kind of.
Like a Charmin commercial.
We're using innuendo now on this season of Black Bag. Okay? Is everyone cool with that? We're going to be innuendo-y. And that's okay.
Okay.
Cool. Instantly in your end.
So does he have a phobia now?
No, not one.
Or can bears get phobias?
Wow, you are just...
I'm just wondering.
He will get either a phobia or a mania. No.
Give him a mania. That sounds relevant. Your mania is your killing thing.
Well,
no.
Oh no. Shucks. If I do that, I have to do manias from here.
Oh no.
Feels like.
Oh. When he has to look at a
see, now
chart.
I have to take the goddamn things off because if I. Jesus. Don't
us.
Get old. There you go. All right.
Better to burn out.
Fade away. Kill yourself at 30 like they did on Logan's Run.
There you go, guys. I heard it here first.
Ah, the fiery see, ritual of carousel.
I
ran away. I ran away and I should have just stayed. I would have been much happier.
God is damn. That why I have a gem in my hand?
Yeah. And it's black because you're over 30. You're fucked.
I haven't seen Logan's Run.
I haven't either.
Great.
That's because you're under 30.
Nope.
Aww.
It's a good movie. Well.
Now I feel old.
I've seen a lot of animated
so you though. Have decided that you want him to do Mania, correct? Okay.
Well, no, you
Jordan has
an
decided
option.
Oh, it's on you. You are going to do Mania.
Yeah.
It's Jordan's fault.
It's my fault.
Here we go. I have the list here. Please roll 2 10-sided die.
Two ten-sided die?
Come at me, Ben. So like a D100 or two D10?
D100, people, come on.
Well, there is a difference.
Oh, Christ. Fuck it.
Technically, he's right.
I know.
You rolled two tens, please.
I rolled a 60-70.
What'd you roll?
6,070. What does that say in your book?
Three.
Ooh. Three.
Three.
That's probably a
good
one.
That's either really good or really bad.
Yeah.
They're either very smart or very dumb.
Or very odd.
Odd like a fox.
A clumena? A-C-H-L-U-O mania. A-C-H-L-U-O.
A-cluomania?
A-cluomania?
Okay.
Or a clitomania?
Siri.
I'm sorry, I didn't understand that.
Which
I
is?
Can't find that movie.
Did you mean Clue?
Now purchasing Clue.
Does that mean that I'm obsessed with the movie Clue?
Yes.
No, it says...
That's what they call them.
Oh, I wish you had rolled a one.
Next time.
Next time. An excessive liking of darkness.
Cool.
I shit you not.
Yeah?
All right.
I like darkness.
Out of curiosity, what was the one?
I'm not gonna tell you. So when you roll
one,
okay. It can
so
be fun.
Okay, so okay, great. So when
stick
I get
around.
It.
Stick around.
So really, I've just become like the emo yourself. Kid from high school.
Only yeah, you're a werebear.
A werebear who's obsessed with darkness.
Yes.
This is amazing.
You're the
darkness,
best character.
My old friend.
Whoosh. All right. So. One's, you're attacking one, or
no,
what?
No,
wait, hold on, can I attack him?
He's running towards you. You've got, you're at disadvantage you're gonna be at disadvantage because of the mania. You're just kind of wanting to run into the darkness.
So I'm just at regular.
It's a good thing you turned off all the torches.
You're just at regular.
And then all
just
of the,
right this one.
All the okay. fire went out on the wall.
So yeah. He's gonna come up and swing at you, or are you attacking first?
I'm attacking him.
Okay, give me a roll.
Here's just as good as anywhere else for darkness.
54 under my 59.
All right, so let me see.
So barely. Not as a
hey,
pun.
Barely.
That's
not as a
success.
Pun. Not as a
that's
pun.
That's a success.
It
success.
Is.
That's all that matters.
Okay. That's
49. Snakes.
49, so he hits.
What, I hit?
No, he dodges, I'm sorry.
Oh, okay.
Sorry. So he
critical
dodges.
Dodge.
And yeah, suddenly now he's just right on top of you. His tentacles are flying everywhere. Mm-hmm. He's gonna grab
it's
you.
Kind of like the Valkyries, but
not
different.
Yeah, it's totally different.
It's disgusting.
A little more gross. Yeah.
Like they're coming out of like would be his rib bones.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he's got a couple of nipple ones.
Ah! No!
Of course. Wait a minute. I thought those was Vikings.
No.
And not Japanese.
No, it's not Japanese.
Yet.
He's just got long nipples.
Let's just make it real.
So we'll get to his attack when we get to me.
So I see
these people around. Species? Everybody's fighting around you. You notice that he has
definitely
this one huge creature attacking him, and everyone else has kind of gone away. And then You see Inga fighting with people over there. Now, she's doing a decent job, but she's also blind, and she's surrounded by people. So your choices are you can defend the back, because there are creatures coming from behind. You can help Inga, or you can try to help.
Can I do something else? Because I have another idea.
Or something else. I'm just showing what's going on around
you. I gotcha. What I want to do is I see that our people are kind of falling back, and they're a little dispirited because they are facing these abominations that they weren't anticipating. They're anticipating regular, you know, another tribe, another set of Vikings. So what I want to do is use my oratory skill to inspire the people around me with one of the epics.
Okay.
And what I want to do is remind them of the bravery of Hadraga and the raid of Fjeld.
Okay.
And which men held the line against abominations that came from the sea.
So, for you to do that, I need you to roll against your... Do you have a skill in
I have oratory.
Give me that roll.
Because I'm a Skald.
Skald!
Yeah.
And then so I'm going to put you on the spot.
Yeah, I can... Oh, I'm going to have to come up with something right now?
Yes.
I mean, you came up with that name.
Now,
during everyone else's turn. I didn't think I was going to tell
the story. I'll be nice. You'll make the roll. We'll go around once. When we get back to you, you have to do your roll. You have to do your thing. So, let's see if you even can do it.
Helga.
That is, in fact, a hard success.
Speech.
Okay, cool.
Speech.
So
speech.
I did really good at that.
All right, cool. So when we get back to you, have something ready. All right. So it is my turn now. This thing's running up the hill at you. And it's about to lunge at you, but it stops for just a moment as if it recognizes you. And gives you a chance. Explain what your pro-glory is again.
They're essentially the same thing. It's just it turns out good or it turns out bad. So basically, I'm recognized for just something I have done or recognized because I go out and do all these crazy things. And when it's good, when it's a pro, it's a benefit. So, like, it would be maybe somebody recognized me that I was going to fight and they got scared and ran away, or somebody recognized me and said, oh, have a free night at the inn because you helped my family or something.
So as this thing's getting closer to you, it starts to lunge towards you and it stops just short. And as you're looking into its eyes, right, even as alien as they are, there's something in its eyes that are recognizable and something familiar. It doesn't say anything, but it just turns around and starts running down the hill away from you.
That's right!
James V. 1971 gave you your pro.
Thank you, James V.
Now, you can attack it as it's turning around, because like I said, it's not on its legs normally. It's usually in the water.
Did I recognize something in it?
You recognize something in it.
Like, did more specifically than just,
Yeah.
So, like, something like, that's a bad recognition?
Somebody you knew at some point. He looked familiar.
I don't know. How big are its teeth?
Its teeth are pretty big. Yeah,
I'm just going to try and attack it. Okay. I would have my sword. It's running away.
Yeah, I'll give you an advantage to your hit.
You know what? Since I'm up higher, I want to run after it and basically jump with my sword, you know, and come down like this.
Okay, absolutely.
Wonder Woman now.
Give me a roll. Yeah,
slow motion trailer style.
All right.
Zack Snyder it.
And you have advantage.
Oh.
But you don't need it.
Well, I don't need it.
Unless you roll less than zero.
I rolled a 9.
Oh, no. Wait, hold on. I mean, you have all those.
Come on, let's so roll. Cool.
No. Okay.
No. Well, she's got advantage. All use your token.
You go for it.
Wait. Okay. Wait. So I didn't roll it.
Re-roll everything.
Re-roll everything.
Okay. Yeah.
16.
I got a 16.
Hold on.
No. Okay. I'll let it go.
He says no.
So you jump, and you're flying up in the air, and it's an awesome view.
Oh, yeah.
This creature is kind of going, and people are like, "Ooh!" Everything, wah, 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 slow up in the air, and you slam your sword down into his head, Was it a hard success or a?
Well, this one got was a 16.
So is that extreme?
No, it's hard though. Oh no, wait, that's my brawl. 15 would be my extreme.
Okay, so but still, it's really good.
I did have it.
Give me damage, and then I'm going to give you a bonus damage for coolness.
Damage Wes.
Damage Wes. Plus 1d Wes.
Okay. Really? 5.
Okay. So what we'll do is we'll put plus 10 on that because you flew up in the air, and you, the force that you went down.
I'm like riding it now.
And you're on top of it.
Yeah.
Like Legolas. Crunch.
What's your ride?
Pretty good, actually.
I wanted to ride.
And it slides, it falls forward because it's you know, on its
Where knees. Are the other ones?
The other ones have spanned out towards the bottom.
Is there anyone, like, kind of near me? Because I really kind of want to ride it right into another.
Well, you didn't crit succeed, so we're not at that level of awesome. So you slam down and you toboggan it for a few feet, definitely.
The only one that sees it is the red tunic.
And it's you know, coughing a little bit, and it kind of rolls over. Oh!
You got lucky!
Dude!
Thanks for following.
That was right at a perfect spot. Thanks, Dom.
He died.
You'll need this. Don't go alone.
It's dangerous to go.
It's
alone.
Dangerous out there.
Paraphrase.
So, Merlin, it's like it's time to talk to you, but blood keeps bubbling up in the back of its monster.
How do you know my name? Of you?
He's behind you.
Behind me?
Behind me?
I want to pull my sword out and turn around really fast.
Okay. As you're doing this, you notice that Rex Gap is right behind you with a sword just about to stab you.
Okay.
So he's going to get to swing first because he was able to be sneaky, sneaky.
Rex sucks everywhere.
Let's see. Okay. All right. So that is a 60? No,
yes.
No. Yeah, no. That's a 60.
Yeah.
So he misses you because the creature warned you.
Yeah.
You kind of moved out of the way right as he swung. Mm-hmm. So you can attack now.
Mm. Well. So he just tried to attack me.
Yes.
This is, okay. I think instead, you know what? I'm gonna take my sword hilt and try and hit him in the face.
Okay, so you're doing like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so is that still sword?
Oh, shit.
Or is that?
96, yeah, it's still sword. And in any instance, 93 is not.
That ain't gonna do nothing. Push it real good.
Really?
You've got a really high sword skill.
I know I do. Okay.
That's one of the safest pushes at the table is you pushing a sword skill.
Yep, 42.
All right.
My 75.
So you try to hit him in the, well, he does get a dodge because he is a named character.
He got the 93.
Oh, he does. Oh, actually, you know what? I'm going to re-roll that.
Oh, no, he used power.
He used a thing.
It's 34.
Woohoo! You miss him.
Wow.
Thank you.
I've taught you well.
Okay.
17-year-old says.
I'm older than you.
All right.
But is it Rex?
Yeah, it's Rex Gap.
It's Rex
Gap.
But
is it?
Well, yes.
It looks like him.
But is it?
All right,
I
so it's your turn. You can attack back.
He dodged out of the way. What's he dodged, doing now?
Well, he's going to swing at you again, but it's your attack right now.
I pretty much want to try and hit him with the sword hilt again and see. I literally want to be able to push him down on the ground with my sword.
Okay, so you stand up, you tower over him, and though he's above you.
I'm like, hey! So, okay, sword. 25. That is a hard success.
Okay, cool. So he is going to try to dodge, and unless I get a hard success or
better,
94. No, not at all. So
you
want to
re-roll
smack
that?
Him. No, I don't actually. Okay. I'm gonna save
I mean, you've
my
got a lot, so you can.
I've got two more. I'm not gonna waste them all on this.
You're gonna wait till I need to not trip over like a root.
Yes, that was my plan the whole time.
Damn it!
All right. Suddenly, there's a lot of roots
out of nowhere.
There's roots everywhere. Now you know what the root of the problem.
Do I roll damage for this?
You started it.
Did I?
Yeah, you
maybe
did.
Maybe
I appreciate it.
I feel like puns.
By living.
You think puns are Jordan's thing?
What?
Yeah.
I think that's true.
I don't know.
Roll damage.
Did I roll my sword damage?
Well, are you trying to damage him or just subdue him?
A little bit of both, but not like, I'm not stabbing him.
I want to subdue him, but give him a little bloody.
I want to figure out what the hell he's doing.
Okay, so just do damage and then it'll be non-lethal, let's say.
7.
Okay, so yeah, you knock him straight back on. Let me make a dex check to see. Just real quick. Fucking A.
Llama!
That wasn't as bad as normal.
Llama!
So let's see, that's a...
73?
Or is that a 17?
I think it was a 73.
No,
I
73.
Just, I have no idea how you even read those things.
It's hard to do. I think having one eye makes it easier?
Possibly.
It's all that nonsense.
So yeah, he slides straight back, hits the ground, and you got your sword on
him. What are you doing?
Fulfilling a destiny for you, and he takes his hand right here where his knife is, and he tries to get you in the...
I do have my sword right here.
You do. Oh. And his sword is like this, and he's trying to get you like that.
Just like...
Idiot!
Right in this pretty Mussolini much. Smiling.
Mussolini smiling.
Well, if he smiles at me, I'm certainly going to do that.
Oh, he's totally...
Oh, well, yeah.
He's totally got a dick smile.
Kill the shit out of that guy.
Those are some purple dice.
That is 19.
Well, you can read them right here.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so yeah, unless you...
can I use my shield?
You know, you're not. You're you, both hands right here. You can try to
it's
dodge.
On my back.
But he's got back. He's got a...
your turtle power in?
Yes.
He's got a really, you know, like you've got to do an extreme or he's got you good.
Mm.
61.
Nope.
No.
Mm. Nope.
Do you want to push it?
That's the last push.
Hold on. You need a 7.
I need a 7?
You need an extreme success on your dodge, which means you need to roll under a 7. So don't do
maybe
it.
Maybe not a good push.
No? Okay.
Take the shank.
The shonk?
6 points.
It shanks
you. So you feel the blade go like between... Your rib and like just like
seven.
So not good. Yeah.
No, that isn't good.
But it pisses you off.
Yeah, it does. And he's smiling at me.
We'll be right back to where you and we're gonna go eat.
You start turning into a bear.
We're all bears.
You're a bear and you're a bear and you're a bear. Reach under your sheet, your chair, and
a bear.
Woo-hoo! I mean, I'm still attacking Nipple.
Nipple guy is right on you.
Yeah.
Go for the nipples.
Nipples.
Yeah, I'd like to.
They grow back.
With my bear maw.
The nipple squid.
By his chest?
Yeah.
All right, go for it, give me a roll.
Am I still at disadvantage?
No.
Careful, he lactates acid.
No one told me that before! 20.
Nice.
20. So you grab onto his chest and because literally it's
your
about
mouth?
High. Yeah.
Yeah.
He's a bear.
I'm a fucking gross, bear.
Man. He has tentacles there.
He's a motherfucking bear!
So, let me see what bear bite damage is again.
It was really terrible.
It's horrible.
Page 32.
It's really terrible.
Bear bite glasses.
Alphabetical.
It should be extra, because not only is it bear,
like 2D,
a,
I think it was 2D10 when I got
berserker
ravaged.
Bear.
When you got ravaged.
By the bear.
By the bear.
Not by the Valkyrie, which we stopped instantly.
I mean, I really
that didn't
I wish
do
that you
any
had.
Damage.
Only to our PG rating.
Yes.
Wait, we have a PG rating?
Well, we did.
I feel like that went out the door the first episode of the first season.
It was a new season. We had a new shot with the sensors.
Getting rid of the hooker really kind of put us in.
That
really kind of puts you where you're going to be.
That's true. The first thing we ever did was get rid
Bubbles.
Of a dead hooker.
Bubbles wasn't dead.
We thought she was.
She was just
We got rid
sick.
Of a live hooker. That's worse.
Good point.
She's just resting.
Are you listening to this, Dom? This is what I want for my bachelor party.
A dead hooker?
I'm getting rid of a live hooker.
No thanks.
Bye. <just saying>.
Here's your money.
Here's
bye.
Your goodie bag. Thanks for coming.
All right, so yes, 2d6.
Oh, 2d6?
Yeah. This one's 2d6.
Support your child.
If you guys are wondering what we're talking about with all these live hookers and dead hookers, be sure to check the replay of Black Bag Season 1, Episode 1 on Twitch.
I think that was the Denny's episode, too.
No, the Denny's episode was like 2 or 3.
No, because so I saw the Denny's episode. I don't know what you're talking about with dead hookers, though.
That is 9.
Right in the nipples.
Do I have any bonus?
No, but 9 is pretty substantial.
Yeah.
In this game, it's not like D&D, you know.
I mean, I'd like to do more. Eliminate him with my mouth.
So you rip out a piece of his skin. Why'd you say it?
Why'd you say it like that?
He wants to finish him with his mouth.
He wants to finish him off with his mouth. Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
You got all new, all mature, super serious Black Bag. Thanks for tuning in.
Yeah.
But no, you know.
That's where we draw the line.
We won't even say the word.
I gave
no
up.
I
gave up about, like, you know, last game. I'm
Hey,
like,
man.
It's going to be what it's going to
be. All
it's all fun. Thanks. I appreciate that.
But yeah.
So, yeah, you now have a mouthful of this guy. And
it's not getting better, though. We all have the opportunity to make this better, and we're not. We're actively not.
It's on us.
We're the monsters.
I blame the mead. I'm sorry.
I will say.
He's sober.
Yeah, I am. I'm just having fun.
He blames the glass.
So you do a good amount of damage. This thing's like, oh, it's lost a tentacle. It's
I spit it back in his face.
Okay. Ew. All right, he's going to try to hit you.
Yeah. Yes?
He's going to try to, like, smack you in the head.
Cool.
20,
you
bend it.
Did you want 5,020 or 2,050?
I wanted 90. He misses you.
Reroll?
Oh, that's true. I will use a reroll.
Whose side are you on?
Well, yeah.
All right, it hits you.
Can I dodge it?
Nah, yes, you can dodge it.
Dodge.
Use your bear dodge.
It's the best kind of dodge.
Bear dodge.
Bears are known for dodging. That's the D&D spell, bears dodge.
77. I do not dodge.
Do you want to push it? What's your dodge?
My dodge I don't think he can push after I use a reroll, right? Or
No, he can't push your reroll.
So if you can push his roll, you can. You only have one push.
Yeah.
I have enough.
Oh, you do?
He has a personal push.
Personal push?
It's up to you, man.
Personal push.
How many hit points do you have?
17.
Oh, I'm sure you'll be fine.
I'll be fine.
Let me roll my 3d17 here.
Is the
my
GM D's smiling?
I need my calculator.
Why is it a d100?
It's a d10.
Is that an abacus?
Eek!
8 points. Ooh. Crunch!
I am.
You actually hear that from across the way.
Oh!
Hear this whap!
I'm at 9.
Yeah.
Wow, you're like down to normal human hit points now.
What do you want to do back?
What do I want to do back?
Yes.
I want to go for his throat.
Okay.
Can I do that right now?
Can you do that?
Can I do that right now?
Sure.
Let's finish this.
Throw.
Ooh.
No,
I'm gonna
push.
Push it.
Yeah. I'm gonna push.
Sorry.
Jesus Christ.
Oh my God!
You gotta touch everything.
Oh my God.
Did you miss?
Yeah, I did.
Oh.
A
68 misses.
Yeah, because I have a 59.
Oh no!
Unless my bear damage, my bear attack is better than my
better.
Axe
not,
attack.
Not so much. All right, so
yeah.
You lunge, and this thing takes its tentacles and wraps it around you and picks you up off the ground and throws you into the water.
I mean, it's a win for Godzilla, but...
Just throws you. Now, remember I said it's very shallow.
Uh-huh.
And you guys are next to, like, the pier and everything, so you're going to hit hard because you're heavy.
Does he have any, like, regeneration or anything since he's aware?
We don't know that yet.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. Do I have any regeneration?
Do we, Elder Gods? Does he have any?
Is it like Wolverine style? Like, real
like
quick?
Instantaneous?
Because that'd be something.
That'd be real nice. You
know, it'd be an interesting story beat.
I'll give you an Amy wink.
You slam into the water and hit the ground, and this thing starts coming at you again.
Sure.
Oh, you're lucky. Ooh.
Nice.
I'm gonna use my last reroll.
On a damage roll.
On a damage roll.
One.
Six. So you're down to 3 points.
I'm down to 3 points. I'm flashing red right now.
You start to feel like you're not as berry as you used to be.
Berry.
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 Barely.
You start to, you're feeling weird. Like you're starting to lose your berserker.
I need a heart.
Olaf Berserker. All right.
Is it harder?
All right. So, first of all, I have to say, I actually feel pretty good about this, considering that I wrote it.
I mean, you wrote a lot, man.
Yes.
So I'm going to go ahead and give you the quickly written.
Can we zoom in on him?
The quickly written epic of Hadraga and the Reld and the Great Raid of Gjeld.
Hold on.
We're getting your close up.
Yeah.
Don forgot to put on his pants again.
Don had to put on his shirt and then come, yeah.
Damn it.
There it is.
Yeah, let's get in nice and close.
There it is.
Nice. Oh, okay.
That's very close.
A little too close.
Too close. Good. That's close.
I'm ready, Mr. DeMille. I'm going to take pictures of you taking pictures.
A meta.
Okay, here we go. This is...
This is the epic of Hadraga and the Great Raid of Fjeld.
Now remember, you're saying this over battle.
Yes.
So
I don't think you want me to blow out the mics because I can't.
Maybe just a little. Yes. Not that loud. No. Damn it. Fine.
Dom ruins all of our fun with technicalities.
All right. Go ahead.
Hardy Hadraga led his iron men to force Fjeld to fealty. The vile villains were in league with hell, holding horrors in their hall. With wailing weird, they burst from bounds and assailed Hadraga's heroes. But brave Jarl Hadraga bolstered faithful followers. Steel soldiers solidly held the line, leaving no abomination alive. Strength of arm leads to strength of heart, and doughty defense defends loyal men, driving darkness back into the sea.
That's really fucking cool.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Fucking alliteration.
That was
guys.
Great.
Oh, I don't know if I can. Just murder. I got this. Here we go.
I don't know if I can do that. That's too
really
quick.
Really appreciate it.
Let me just, you know.
I am.
Thanks, Dom.
Really. Woohoo. Don't you zoom in. Dom.
Give him bare face.
Give him
Dom. No one's even seeing this right now. It's not even on. No one can even see this. No one can even see this. Dom.
Yeah. So.
Dom.
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 Dom. Dom. Dom.
Dom.
Dom.
Dom. Dom.
Yeah.
This is terrifying.
Oh, God! Ah! Somebody has to clip that, right? DJ Regular, are you out there, man?
Can someone gif it?
Oh, please.
Gif it!
Somebody.
Good.
Holy shit.
Good. That'll haunt our nightmares. So what awesome bolstering effect does that amazing
do I not have 3 points?
What does it do? What would you like it? What would your?
I think that what it does is it reminds all the people of Stavanger that they are strong, hardy folk, and that they can drive back this abomination from their shores. Into the sea, showing that their strength is greater than anything that can be thrown against them.
Okay, so that starts happening. They start fighting stronger, fighting harder, and they start pushing back the people who are coming from behind and on the sides back into the water, okay? And it gives you a clear shot to where Inga is fighting. The person she's fighting has his back to you.
Okay.
So if you want to attack, you can.
Yes, I will run over there and stab that guy in the back because I am not. Because honor schmatter.
Right. We're not.
It's
yeah.
not for honor.
42 is plenty good. That's a success.
All right.
Plenty good.
So you hit. He's not going to get a dodge because he's turned away from you. Give me a roll against your, give me your damage.
Okay.
Whoa.
Nice.
That is going to be 11.
11. Well, it's 11 on the die.
No, that's only 2, so it's 10. It's a d8 plus a d4 divided by 2.
Ah.
1 and 2 are 1.
You weren't here last time.
3 and 4 are 2. So it's 10 points.
10 points. Okay. So you stab this thing in the back pretty hard and go right through like its spinal column or whatever, spinal cord.
Splurch.
And it falls. And Inga's just swinging around, right? She's got this huge sword that she's swinging. Like, where are you? Oh, damn it, I'm gonna kill you.
Inga, it's clear, it's clear.
Oh, okay.
Back up and help the wounded.
Oh, okay, okay, okay. I heard a speech. It was a good speech. Was that you?
Yes.
Okay, good, good.
Thank you.
All right. Sounds good. All right, where are our dead people and where are injured people? I had a helper and he ran away.
There's one in the water.
I assume there's people falling all over the place.
Okay, there are downed people. Downed people.
So I'll direct her to the two closest. Oh, to your left, to your left.
All right.
Other left.
To your left, to your left. To your left, to your left.
Okay, so she starts helping people. All right, so you have gotten down and gotten away from this guy who's following you.
Yeah.
Where are you going in particular? The wall has given in.
Okay.
And you notice that they're setting fires at the different buildings.
Hmm. Wait, what about all the people that were at the wall?
They're fighting but not winning.
Okay.
They're getting pushed back because there was no...
These are just normal Vikings though, right?
Yeah.
Holy crap.
No leaders were with them, so they're getting kind of hacked to pieces.
Okay.
James V. 1970, what?
Wait
for it. James V. 1971 gives you 10 hit points.
Whoa!
Wow!
Whoa!
That heals me fully to my normal human strength.
Thank you! Thanks.
I'm at my regular hit points, 13.
Thank you, James V.
Thank you, James V. I promise I'll just water them.
The water just kind of cleans out your wounds and makes you feel better for some reason.
That's canon.
Yep. It's.
Get in the water.
You notice a beautiful Viking. Why am I forgetting their names? Valkyrie standing over you, and she looks you in the eyes, and then slaps you really hard across the face.
I love it.
You wake up.
That's what I'm really into.
And then she just disappears.
Magnus is back. And is what I scream.
In the water.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's canon.
Okay, so fires are being lit in the village. Any of them?
James V also gives you 5 points back.
Yay! Thank you, James V.
Nice.
You get like a really sexy Viking dude standing over you. And just like gently strokes your face.
He's got a tub of, I cannot believe it's not butter or something.
Oh,
yeah.
Really long flowing hair.
He brought margarine, like all sexy
like
guys
all
do.
All sexy guys do. You know.
I'm here and I brought the butter substitute. You're welcome.
Yeah, exactly.
Anyway. Now I know you better play.
So cool.
It's cheaper than regular butter.
And slightly less dangerous for you. It's probably more dangerous.
More dangerous for you.
It's got nails in it. Anyway.
Are any of the fires getting close to the central?
Yes.
Okay.
Actually starting to get.
I want to start trying to extinguish any fires that are spreading towards the central
How
lodge.
How are you doing that?
Hopefully at this point they are small enough since they're not the initial blazes. So I want to start trying to bury them with like dirt and sand or whatever's around. I want anything that is like smaller blazes that are starting to encroach towards the central hut. I want to try and keep away.
Okay, cool.
Just kicking snow on it.
Yeah, snow or mud, whatever
you can to start.
Yeah, just to stifle it.
Anything that's getting close to the thing. So you again, you have people kind of you're starting to stream through as the.
I got healed too.
As the thank you, Elder Gods, for healing.
Yeah,
as they start to lose ground at the gate, so you see more and more of them, and you're trying to put out these fires. That's what you're doing until we get around to me, and then we'll go back.
Yeah.
To all right. So he stabbed you.
Yeah, but I feel better now.
It felt really bad, but now
did it heal over the wound? Like, is the knife still in there?
No, I imagine he like kind of stabbed just, and yeah. Boop. My body was, I just went, and it just
You just bared down?
Yeah.
No.
Nobody
responded. Hit one of those other things.
No one responded. Pretend like Ben's not here.
No one. He only survives off of your last.
Where is the cookie butter? Give me the cookie butter.
All right. So, what do you do?